Welcome back. In this video, we are going to discuss about improper integrals of type 3, as well as we will discuss about the comparison test. Based on that, also we can say that the given improper integral is convergent or divergent. So let us start with first improper integrals of kind 3, or you can say type 3. Whenever we have the combination of the type 1 and type 2, and that it will be improper integral of the type 3. For example, integration that is 0 to infinite 1 divided by x dx. But when you see the infinite limit is there, so it is improper integral of the type 1. But when we see the x is equal to 0, so 1 divided by 0, that is going to be the unbounded, or you can say discontinuous at x is equal to 0. So therefore, it is improper integral of type 2. So combination of the type 1 and type 2, so it will be the type 3. So let us evaluate integration, that is 0 to infinite 1 divided by x dx. So here it is clear that the upper limit is the infinite and lower limit, that is going to be the function unbounded. So it is the type 3. Whenever we solve this kind of improper integrals, so we need to consider any constant between 0 to infinite such that this function is going to be the infinite. So therefore, I am just assuming that the integration that is 0 to 1 and 1 to infinite. So let us first focus on the first improper integration, that is 0 to 1, 1 divided by x dx. So limit t tends to 0 plus integration t to 1, 1 divided by x dx. But when you integrate with respect to x, so what you will get ln x over that is 0 t to 1. But when we put upper limit, so ln 1, and when we put the lower limit, so we will get the minus ln mod t. But ln 1 is nothing but 0, but when we take the limit, so you will get the answer that is infinite. And therefore, we can say this improper integral is nothing but divergent. So addition of the two improper integral is divergent, or one is divergent, other is the convergent. So ultimately, it will be the divergent. And hence, we can say that this improper integral does not exist. Then we have the p integral test. Integration 1 to infinite 1 divided by x raised to p dx is convergent if p is greater than 1 and divergent if p less or equal 1. So if p is equal 1, then the integration 1 to infinite 1 divided by x dx, that can be written as infinite is replaced by b, then we will assume that the limit b tends to infinite. But when we integrate with respect to x, so we will get the ln x over 1 to b. So ln b minus ln 1, ln 1 is nothing but 0. So final we obtained that the ln b, when we take the b tends to infinite, so it is going to be the infinite. So the given improper integral, when we have the p is equal 1, so it will be the divergent. But what about the p is not equal 1? So in that case, what we can assume that the p is greater than 1, or we can assume that the p less than 1. So our given improper integration 1 to infinite 1 divided by x raised to p dx, that can be written as limit t tends to infinite integration 1 to t 1 divided by x raised to p dx. But when we integrate with respect to x, so I will get x raised to minus p plus 1 divided by minus p plus 1. But when I put the upper limit, so what I will get, that is the t raised to minus p plus 1 divided by minus p plus 1 minus 1 raised to finite quantity, so it will be the 1 minus p plus 1. But from the both the terms, what I can take, that is the common quantity, that is 1 minus p is nothing but common quantity. So I will get t raised to minus is common, so I can write in bracket p minus 1, and minus 1 is there. So 1 divided by 1 minus p, that can be written as 1 divided by t raised to p minus 1 minus 1. But when we apply the limit, so first we have the case number 1, p greater than 1, that can be written as p minus 1 is greater than 0, and therefore t raised to p minus 1 tends to infinite as t tends to infinite, and 1 divided by t raised to p minus 1 tends to 0. So our improper integral, this is going to be the 0, so what I will get, minus 1 divided by 1 minus p, and that can be written as 1 divided by p minus 1. So therefore the corresponding improper integrals, whatever we have, that going to be convergent as we have the case p greater than 1. But what about the case when we have p less than 1? So that can be written as p minus 1 is less than 0, and therefore the 1 divided by t raised to p minus 1, it can be written as t raised to 1 minus p, that tends to be infinite as t tends to infinite. So therefore the given improper integrals, when we have the case p less than 1, it will be the divergent. So therefore integration 1 to infinite 1 divided by x raised to p is converges for p greater than 1 and diverges for p less or equal 1. Now we have the comparison test. So first we talk about the direct comparison test. Suppose we have given that f of x and g of x both are continuous function for x greater or equal than, such that this is going to be happening. So corresponding, if we have the upper improper integral, that is the integration a to infinite g of x dx is convergent, then the smaller one improper integral, that will be the what exactly convergent. If we have this, both the functions are continuous for x greater or equal a, and we get this relation. If we have the lower one improper integration, that is a to infinite g of x diverges, then the bigger one integration a to infinite f of x dx diverges. Now we have the limit comparison test. If f of x and g of x both are continuous function for x greater or equal a, such that f of x and g of x both are positive, then limit x tends to infinite f of x divided by g of x is a well limit L, where L is better than 0 to infinite, then the corresponding both improper integrals simultaneously convergent or divergent. But if we have the lower one improper integral, say integration a to infinite g of x dx, and that is a convergent, then definitely we can say the upper one improper integral, that is integration a to infinite f of x dx, will be the convergent. And the same way, improper integral of g of x dx is the divergent, then definitely we can say that the upper one improper integral also, it will be the divergent. So let us see first question. Test the convergence of the improper integral, that is 1 to infinite cos x divided by x squared dx. But here from this question we are not able to say that the what will be the exact value of this improper integral, but we can definitely say that this is the improper integral that will be the convergent or divergent. So in that case, cos function is bounded by 1. So what I can say, cos x is bounded by 1, but when we divide by x square, so I will get 1 divided by x square. So this is our g of x, and left hand side whatever we have the function f of x. But from this, what we have obtained, that f of x is less or equal g of x. So we can say upper one improper integral, say g of x, 1 divided by x square is there, and corresponding this improper integral is going to be what exactly convergent by the P series test, P integral test. What is the P integral test? As earlier we discussed that integration 1 to infinite 1 divided by x raised to P dx is convergent if we have the P is greater than 1, and divergent if we get the P is less or equal 1. Instead of that, also you can say according to the type 1 improper integral, you may assume that infinite is replaced by B, and then after take the limit B tends to infinite, but when you solve, so you will get the answer 1, and which is the finite quantity, and therefore what we can say, the upper one improper integral corresponding to g of x is nothing but convergent, and hence lower one f of x, so corresponding to that improper integral, that is 1 to infinite cos x divided by x square dx, will be the convergent according to the direct comparison test. Next one, we have to test the convergence of the improper integral e raised to minus x square dx. So here it is clear that the e raised to minus x square is continuous function on the interval, that is 1 to infinite. Since x square is greater or equal, that is x, so minus times x square is less or equal minus x, so e raised to minus x square less or equal e raised to minus x. But now you can say this is our g of x, and left hand side this is what our f of x, so this is our given function, and this is what our g of x. But we can say the improper integral, that is 1 to infinite g of x, but g of x is nothing but e raised to minus x, and when we solve this question using the type 1 improper integral, I will get the answer, that is e raised to minus 1, which is the finite quantity, and therefore the smaller one improper integral, that is integration, that is 1 to infinite e raised to minus x squared dx, will be the what exactly convergent according to the comparison test. Then we have check the convergence of integration 4 to infinite 3x divided by 5 divided by x raised to 4 plus 7 dx. This is the polynomial form in the numerator as well as the denominator. Whenever you see the polynomial form in the numerator as well as the denominator, just apply the limit comparison test. So here clearly function f of x, that is a 3x plus 5 divided by x raised to 4 plus 7 is there. So corresponding From this f of x, we can choose g of x by assuming the highest power common from the numerator as well as from the denominator. So what I will get, x divided by x raised to 4, so it will be 1 divided by x raised to q. Now I'm just assuming limit x tends to infinite f of x divided by g of x. So it will be limit x tends to infinite 3x plus 4 divided by x raised to 4 plus 7 divided by g of x. So what I can say, 1 divided by, but it can be written as a numerator. Now I'm just going to take x common from the numerator and x raised to 4 common from the denominator. So what I will get, x times 3 plus 5 by x divided by x raised to 4 into 1 plus 7 divided by x raised to 4 into x raised to cube divided by 1. But you can see that the x raised to 4 will be cancelled out. But when you take the limit, so what you will get, that is 3 divided by 1, that is a finite and non-zero quantity. And therefore, what we can say, both the improper integrals will be convergent or divergent together. But when we apply the comparison test, so in that case, particularly conclusion is there, but improper integral, that is 4 to infinite g of x dx, and that is what? G of x is nothing but this one. According to p integral test, integration 1 to infinite 1 divided by x raised to p dx, and that will be the convergent if we have the p is greater than 1, and divergent if we have the p is less or equal 1. So what we can say, this is going to be the convergent, but instead of that, you may assume that the improper integral kind 1. So using that one also, you can find the answer, that is 1 divided by 32, that is the finite quantity. So corresponding to comparison test, so denominator, whatever we have the improper integral, so that is going to be convergent. Therefore, the numerator has to be what exactly improper integral will be the convergent. Like that, integration that is 4 to infinite 3x plus 5 divided by x raised to 4 plus 7 dx is convergent. So in this video, we have discussed about the improper integrals of the type 3, or you may say kind 3, and comparison test. Thank you.